What is the cat coming for? This is Sunday, February 17, 2014. What is the cat coming in for?
Ear infection.
Yeah, scratching, is it?
Yeah.
How does it happen and how long?
Few weeks.
How do you know there's ear infection?
Because the ears get dirty very easy. There's black like wax inside,
wax,
and then you start to...
Wax inside the ears?
All around the ear. Around the inner section of the ear.
It comes out with the wax?
It will be over here as well.
Okay.
In here.
So you've been digging the ears, I guess?
But not too deep.
Too deep, huh? So definitely there is a lot of wax and irritation, so the cat scratches the ear. And I noticed that this part is hairless. Normally they have hair like...
All around.
Because the normal ear will have hairs around like this, this part. So this is a clue to say that the cat always scratches this side.
Okay.
And all the hair is gone, but this side the cat didn't scratch. So it didn't scratch here. So this is the left ear. Now I go to the right ear. And same problem, right?
Yeah.
Now the right ear is here. And hair is lost here. There's hair here and this edge. So the cat has been scratching. Now what comes out here? The same thing?
It's the same.
The ear wax, is it?
Yeah.
Now I'll put the cotton bud in. You can see the scratch reflex.
Yeah.
You see the scratch reflex. This is called the scratch reflex. No? And normally when the cat does that, that means the ear is irritated, itchy. And you see a lot of yellow pus or inflammation. Now this scratch reflex is a very characteristic of ear infection, and you see, but it's not so obvious now. But normally, when it's rough here, so this cat definitely has otitis externa. So otitis externa has to, what causes it? Has it been to boarding?
Has it been?
Boarding? When to?
No, it's been at home.
All the time?
Yes.
So I would think that is the irritation or some shampoo being dropped into it, because the owner bathes the cat every week. Right.
Yeah, the shampoo we use is your green color.
Yeah, but it's not meant to go inside, you see.
We don't put it in.
So normally I would advise cover up with this piece of cloth when it bathe. Plug it, and then when it bathes the whole body.
Then after that, remove the...
So that the water doesn't get in. So in this case, it's probably irritated by the green shampoo. Okay, now we look at the teeth. Now the teeth, I advise you not to brush, right?
Yeah.
I advise not to brush because of ulcer. But as you can see, there's periodontal disease in the back teeth. The tartar is there. So this back teeth, you will need scaling. And then they will keep the infection, the gum gingivitis. This will be periodontal disease, I would say grade 2. There's a bit of loss of attachment. Now I turn over this side to see this, the check the mouth again, and you can see. How long was the last dental scaling?
It should be November, December.
November, December, huh? How long was that? How many months?
Three to four.
3 to 4 months ago, only.
So
the gingivitis, there's no loss of periodontal membrane attachment. So this would be grade 1. Grade 1 is gingivitis and tartar. Normally it affects the back teeth. So we will do some dental scaling, and then ear irrigation under sedation, and after that the owner should not be letting water into the ear canals. It's a very unusual case. Usually cats don't get otitis externa. February 17, 2014, 10 a.m. Toa Payoh.